Himalaya, the land of God. It divides the Tibetan Plateau from the great Indian subcontinent. It all started 225 million years ago in a geologic time. The Pangaea, which means all lands. That was a supercontinent form, a single landmass on Earth. Here, India was a large island and situated off the Australian coast, separated from Asia by the Tethys Ocean. The Pangaea started breaking up, continental plate, the start of Himalayan uplift, and disappearance of the Tethys Ocean. The drifting of the Indian continental plate against the Eurasian plate caused latter to crumple and buckle above the former plate. The folding and faulting caused by the compressional forces of the continental crust caused it to thicken, pushing up the Himalayas and the Tibetan Plateau. Today, the Indian plate continues to drive in horizontally at the Tibetan Plateau, which forces the plateau to continue move upwards. The Indian plate is still moving at 67 mm per year, and over the next 10 million years, it will travel about 1500 km into Asia. About 20 mm per year, India-Asia convergence is absorbed by the thrusting along the Himalayan southern form. This leads to the Himalayan rising by about 5 mm per year, making them geologically active. The movement of the Indian plate into Asian plate also makes the region seismically active, leading to earthquake from time to time. The Himalayan range is one of the youngest mountain range on the planet and consists mostly uplifted sedimentary and metamorphic rock, according to the modern theory of plate tectonics. That was the million years olden story of forming the Himalayas. The Himalayas and the Tibetan Plateau extend for 2,900 km east and west, and the highest elevation is Mount Everest, which is 8,848 meters. And considered the highest point on the earth. The Himalayan range include over 50 mountains exceeding 7,200 meter elevation, including 10 of the 14 8,000 meter peaks. The Himalayas consist of parallel mountain ranges, the Shivalik Hills on the south, which is the lower part of Himalaya, the Great Himalaya, which is the highest and central range, and the Tibetan Himalayas on the north. For the vast size and huge ranges and the complex topography, they experience a wide range of climates, from humid subtropical foothills to cold desert condition on the Tibetan side of the range. The monsoon can seriously impact transport and cause the landslides. It restricts tourism, the trekking and mountaineering. The Himalayas contain the third large deposit of ice and snow in the world, after Antarctica and the Arctic. The Himalayan range encompasses about 15,000 glaciers, which store about 12,000 cubic kilometers of fresh water. The Himalayan region is dotted with many of lakes. Most of the larger lakes are on the northern side of the main range. This includes the sacred lake Mansarovar near to Mount Kailas. The Himalayas is also considered to be the father of river Ganges. Gomukh is the source of the holy river. The flora and fauna of the Himalayas vary with the climate and altitude. The snow leopards lives in high alpine areas above the tree line and up to 18,000 feet in elevation. The Varan, also called the Himalayan blue sheep, that inhabit upland slopes throughout the Himalayas. There are many cultural aspects. Himalayas are home to several tribes, each with their distinct socio-cultural heritage and customs. Their populations are mainly adapted to the challenging topography and the climate of the region. The Himalayas are home to a diversity of medicinal resources. So many people use medicinal plants as their only source of healing in the Himalayas. The plants are an important source of income. In many ways, the Himalayas are unique among the world's mountains. They are taller, younger, and more rugged than other ranges, making the people of India very proud for the mountains.